Imagine building a brand new car. It's a complex process involving thousands of parts and meticulous planning. Every component must fit perfectly and every system must work in harmony. The design phase is just the beginning. You wouldn't just assume it works perfectly, right? You'd want to make sure everything is in order. You'd inspect it closely, checking every detail to ensure it's safe and reliable. You'd take it for a spin, testing it on different terrains, pushing it to its limits, and making sure it performs as expected under various conditions. That's what software testing is all about. Just like a car, software needs to be tested thoroughly to ensure it works correctly. It's not enough to just write the code and hope for the best. We need to make sure our apps and websites work smoothly before we unleash them on the world. This involves testing them on different devices and platforms to ensure compatibility and performance. Testing helps us find and fix bugs, those pesky little errors that can cause crashes and frustration. Bugs can be elusive and tricky, but thorough testing helps us catch them before they become a problem for users. There are many different ways to test software. Each method has its own strengths and focuses on different aspects of the software. Some tests are automated, running scripts to check for specific issues, while others are manual, involving human testers who explore the software in depth. Some tests are very specific, targeting particular functions or features, while others are more exploratory, looking for unexpected issues and ensuring the software behaves well in a variety of scenarios. Today we're going to talk about two fun and interesting types of testing: monkey testing and gorilla testing. These unconventional methods can reveal unique issues that more traditional testing might miss, adding an extra layer of assurance to the software's reliability. Imagine a monkey let loose on a keyboard. The monkey doesn't know what it's doing, right? It just randomly presses keys. That's the basic idea behind monkey testing. It's a type of software testing where random inputs and actions are thrown at an application. The goal is to see if the application crashes or behaves unexpectedly. It's a way to uncover hidden bugs that more structured testing might miss. Think of it as stress testing your app with a healthy dose of chaos. In monkey testing, we don't follow a script. Instead, we embrace the unpredictable nature of randomness. This method is akin to letting a monkey loose in a room full of computers, allowing it to interact with the system in any way it pleases. The monkey, which is usually a software program, operates without any predefined instructions or patterns. We let the monkey, which is usually a software program, go wild. It might click buttons randomly, enter strange data, or perform actions in an illogical order. The key is randomness. This randomness is crucial because it mimics the unpredictable behavior of real users who might not always follow the expected paths when using an application. It might click buttons randomly, enter strange data, or perform actions in an illogical order. The key is randomness. This approach can uncover hidden bugs that structured testing might miss. For instance, a user might accidentally click on a series of buttons that a developer never anticipated, leading to unexpected behavior or crashes. While it might seem chaotic, monkey testing can be surprisingly effective. It helps us find crashes. Does the app crash when unexpected input is received? By simulating these random interactions, we can identify weak points in the software that need to be addressed. This method is particularly useful in stress testing, where the goal is to push the system to its limits and see how it handles extreme conditions. Crashes? Does the app crash when unexpected input is received? This is crucial for ensuring the stability of the application. If an app can handle the chaos of monkey testing, it's more likely to perform well under normal usage conditions. Additionally, this method can reveal performance bottlenecks, where the system slows down or becomes unresponsive under heavy load. Security vulnerabilities: can the monkey access sensitive data? This aspect of monkey testing is vital for identifying potential security risks. By allowing the monkey to interact with the system in unexpected ways, we can uncover vulnerabilities that might be exploited by malicious users. This helps in strengthening the security measures and protecting sensitive information from unauthorized access. Usability issues: is the app difficult to use even with random actions? This is another important aspect of monkey testing. If a user struggles to navigate the app or perform basic functions due to random interactions, it indicates that the user interface might need improvement. By addressing these issues, we can enhance the overall user experience and make the app more intuitive and user-friendly. Monkey testing is like exploring a jungle blindfolded. You have no idea what you'll encounter next, and every step is a surprise. This unpredictability is what makes monkey testing so valuable. It forces us to think outside the box and consider scenarios that we might not have thought of during traditional testing. You might bump into a few trees, but you're also likely to discover hidden paths and unexpected treasures. These discoveries can lead to significant improvements in the software, making it more robust, secure, and user-friendly. In the end, the chaos of monkey testing can lead to the discovery of valuable insights and solutions that might have otherwise remained hidden. Now let's talk about gorillas. Gorillas are strong and focused. They know what they want and how to get it. Gorilla testing is similar. It's a more focused approach compared to the randomness of monkey testing. In gorilla testing, we target a specific feature or module of the application. We hammer that specific area with a large number of tests, trying to break it. We're not just looking for crashes. We're trying to find any and all weaknesses in that specific area. Gorilla testing in action-focused intensity. Let's say we're testing the login functionality of a website. With gorilla testing, we would focus all our energy on that login page. We might try entering invalid usernames and passwords, trying to log in with an empty username or password, testing different password complexities, and seeing how the system handles multiple login attempts. By focusing our testing efforts, we gain a deep understanding of the login module's strengths and weaknesses. This helps us build a more robust and secure application. Monkey versus gorilla, a tale of two tests. So, what's the difference between monkey testing and gorilla testing? These two testing methodologies might sound similar, but they serve very different purposes in the software development lifecycle. Here's a simple breakdown. Monkey testing is a type of random testing that covers the entire application. It involves inputting random, unpredictable data into the system to see how it reacts. Monkey testing covers the entire application, from the user interface to the back-end processes, while gorilla testing focuses on a specific module or feature. This means that instead of testing the whole application, gorilla testing zeroes in on one particular area to ensure its robustness and reliability. Monkey testing uses random, unpredictable input, which can be anything from random keyboard strokes to random mouse clicks. The idea is to simulate unexpected user behavior to uncover hidden bugs. Whereas gorilla testing is more focused and targeted, it involves repeatedly testing a specific module or feature with the same set of inputs to ensure it can handle a variety of scenarios. The goal of monkey testing is to find unexpected crashes and bugs. By inputting random data, testers can identify weaknesses in the system that might not be found through more structured testing methods, while gorilla testing aims to test the robustness of a specific area. This type of testing is particularly useful for critical components of the application that must perform reliably under various conditions. Think of monkey testing as a wide net, cast over the entire application to catch a variety of bugs. It's like casting a fishing net into the ocean, hoping to catch whatever comes your way. Catching a variety of bugs. This method is great for uncovering unexpected issues that might not be caught through more targeted testing. Gorilla testing is more like a laser beam, focusing on a specific target. It's like using a laser pointer to highlight a particular spot, ensuring that it is thoroughly tested and free of defects. Focusing on a specific target. This method is ideal for ensuring that critical features of the application are robust and reliable, providing a high level of confidence in their performance. Real-world examples: monkeys, gorillas, and your apps. Let's say you're building a mobile game. Monkey testing would involve letting the monkey interact with the game randomly, tapping the screen, swiping, and entering random data. This could uncover crashes, glitches, or levels that are impossible to complete. Gorilla testing, on the other hand, would focus on a specific aspect of the game, like the scoring system. You might try entering extremely high scores, negative scores, or scores with special characters to see how the game handles them. Why developers should care: building better software. Understanding monkey and gorilla testing is important for software developers because it helps them build more stable and reliable applications, find and fix bugs early in the development process, improve the overall user experience, and save time and money in the long run. By incorporating these testing techniques, developers can deliver higher quality software that meets the needs of their users. The future of testing: smarter monkeys, stronger gorillas. As technology evolves, so too will software testing. We can expect to see smarter monkey testing tools that use artificial intelligence to generate more intelligent and realistic test cases. Gorilla testing will become even more targeted and sophisticated, employing advanced techniques to push the limits of software and ensure its resilience. The future of software testing is exciting, and it's a field that will continue to evolve alongside the technology it helps to perfect. So that's it for today. Happy testing, and see you next time.